السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Blessings to all of you. Eid Mubarak. So I hope you had a very happy feast and you still have it. And Eid is not always easy because we were fasting so long. However, inshallah, you had a very happy feast. Now, today I want to say something very different, and this is about identification and the process of identification. So there is always these three points that are mentioned: the mind, the emotions, and the body, right? And the New Age and all the others, they say, you are not the body, you are not the thoughts, and you are not your emotions, and so on. Yes, but a few ones only understand what is actually happening and why do they say that, right? So you have to understand, in the moment you have a thought, yeah, that thought wants something, that thought needs something, that thought thinks somewhere, right? And the stronger the thought is, for example, I need to drink, I need to eat this specific thing, I need to visit that specific person, yeah, then you have a kind of pull inside. You pull yourself inside that thought. And the stronger that happens, the stronger you feel that pull inside the thought, the stronger you create your world with that thought. Yeah. And when that thought is accompanied with a strong emotion, then it is the second level of identification. And you get even deeper into this movement that you are pulled inside, yeah, and you are forced yourself into this emotion, right? And then it comes into the body, and when it comes into the body, that is the moment where it manifests completely and where it becomes your world, our world. So in the body is the deepest identification. And this is the reason why we have to leave from this world, to break this identification and to see the effect of liberation after. Yeah. This is the strongest identification, is with the body. And practically all our identifications are noticeable and result in the body. There is no other really important. So we create our world in the moment we bring it into our physical body. And if we don't do that, we don't have this complete entanglement. And the effect of these identifications with our mind, with our emotions, is less, right? So let's say you have this thought that you want to go in a restaurant and you want to eat spaghetti, right? And all day long you think about it, yeah, because this restaurant is an old Italian restaurant and it's very known and it's wonderful. You have been there before. And you come there with your beloved one, and the owner knows you also. And the moment you enter, the owner says, oh, we are so sorry. Tonight we have no spaghetti. Yeah. And as you were already identified with the expectation of having it, yeah, your great, a strong emotion of frustration, and it pulls you inside, and you find your day and your life and maybe everything else around miserable. Yeah. It depends how deep you pull it inside of you. And on a cosmological level, The same happens through the black holes with all our galaxies. There is this hole and the whole galaxy disappears because we are living in a matrix which is not real. It is an illusion. This is what is called it. It's called Dunya, it is called Maya, it is called an illusionary situation, right? So illusion means that you are pulled inside of it, and when you come out of it, you find liberation. So this is the mechanic of illusion. And when we say illusion, we also have to understand that our past, whatever is our past, it is born in that illusion. So there is no past. There is no past, and there is also no future. And this is why, for example, some say, never born, never died, right? Because the illusion is you are sitting in the cinema and you see something happening on the screen in front of you, and you find yourself into the actor's emotion. What they act, even it's not their own emotions, it's not their own life, they act it so vivid that they can pull us inside this movie, and we cry over something which is not our life, right? If it is a drama, if it is a love story, it's a sad story, we cry about something which is not our life. And that's the same process, that when we think and we go into it, we are pulled into it with a great force, then we cry about something which does not exist. So this is the way our ego shields us from reality. So we invent the reality that we want, yeah? Unconsciously, of course. At the moment we are aware of it, we will stop doing that, and we will entering in a situation of liberation. This is not easy to understand, but it is important to understand those three steps. Yeah. That is what is meant when it is said in the sacred texts. Body, emotion, and mind, these three locks, these three bulls, you have to become aware of them. And the more you are aware of it, the less this pull will happen, and you stay stable in your center, in your zero point. This is the only point of stability. There is no other. Yeah. And every time you identify with one of the things, yeah, but especially in your body, you find yourself in a prison. And this is why you want to change. You're looking outside. You want to come outside of something that you even don't know what it is. It's your own world that you want to come outside. Yeah. For this reason, it says, La ilaha illallah. And there is nothing else, and nothing, absolutely nothing else except the divine. Yeah. This is the only presence there is. This is the only reality there is. Everything else is a mirror game, is a reflection game, yeah, that is initiated. And when you are completely identified, then you find yourself in a situation like a video game. Yeah. You are in it, and the way we play video games and we go into these games, yeah, the same thing happens from up, that we are used, that we are played, yeah. Because we identify, and the one who goes out cannot be played anymore and is granted freedom. Yeah. So I hope it is clear, because we are needing this very much. We need this practicing to understand. Otherwise, we are pulled. In every event that comes, that is going to come, it is always going to come something, and we identify, and we get the horror, and we get the shame and we get God knows what. Yeah. But all of this is not truly happening in the sense that you make it yours. Yeah. Yeah. You are not in this war. Yeah. You are not a part of it. You are a part of the thought, of the emotion, of the identification which happens. But do not allow it to bring it into your body. Yeah. And to live in a fear. Yeah. Because this is what happens. You always have to ask yourself, why am I living in fear? Yeah. What is it that makes my life permanently to be bathed in fear, in doubt, in insecurity? It is because you create a world which does not exist. Yeah. And the only drive that can be done to make someone to move out of something is to make him to fear, to be sad, to be angry, to be in a shaking position. So you look for stability. And when you understand this process, you will be very cautious and you want to become aware. That is what it is. Thank you very much and wishing you wonderful life. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.